rocket. You're gonna option us and you're gonna kill us because the number of the enemy more than us. So I slept in the daytime and they woke night time, nobody can see us. And when I go in, up in the mountain, the enemy is down in the mountain. If you light, making fire, the enemy gonna watch the fire and he knows how our number and he will kill us. And Rasulullah accepted that. Yes, sadaqt, sadaqt. You approve it. And tell him, what about you pray and you have water? You have water? Wujud al-ma? Is that wujud al-ma? But what tayammu? How come you pray and you are in a janaba without wudu and the water there? قال يا رسول الله اليوم كان شديد البرد والله لو اغتسلت لمت. If I wash I will die. والله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن قال فلا تقتلوا أنفسكم إن الله كان بكم رحيم. Don't kill yourself. In the Quran said that. So I make التيمم and approve it. رسول الله approve it. So this is the point. If you have this situation and the water is there but you're gonna die or got sick, real sick, don't do it. Just make a tayammum and pray. I'm sorry, it takes a long time, but this is the point. Back again to our alim, Al-Izz ibn Abd al-Salam, Sultan al-Ulama, al-Dimashqi al-Masri. Why do we say Dimashqi al-Masri? Because he started the first stage in Dimashq, in Sham, then he moved to Masr. We say from Dimashq, from Sham, because he started his life in the Sham, in the area of the Sham, and after that he moved to Egypt, in the Masr. Subhanallah. في الوقت ده كان عصر الأيوبيين. العصر الأيوبي. كان الصالح إسماعيل الأيوبي هو اللي حاكم الشام. سلطان شام. وفي مصر كان نجم الدين أيوب. طبعا أقارب. The names of صالح إسماعيل أيوب. Ayyubi, and another one in Egypt, Najm al-Din Ayyub. One uncle and one nephew. واحد عم والتاني ابن اخوه. ولكن حصل بينهم خلاف. You have one day you have problem between relationship, and this is the Sultan Syria, and the other one Sultan Egypt, but have problem. حتى هم أقارب, لكن حصل مشكلة. فاستعان الصالح إسماعيل الصليبيين. So the one he sultan in Syria, he asking the Salibiyin, the Christian people for help. ليس هذا فقط بل أعطاهم تصريح أنهم يدخلوا دمشق ويشترون الأسلحة من العرب. He give him permission. You go inside city of Dimashq and you buy the weapon, the أسلحة, the army. And not only that, وأيضا أعطاهم أرض من الشام. He gave him gift, أرض, land, gift for the صليبيين, for the Christian people. Why? He helped him out. He killed the Muslim people in Egypt. فاستعان سلطان الشام بالصليبيين على قتل المسلمين في مصر. He asked the Christian people to help him out to kill his brother as a Muslim in Egypt. هنا هب العالم العز بن عبد السلام سلطان العلماء. The Sheikh العز بن عبد السلام, our subject today, he was قاضي القضاء. He was قاضي القضاء. يعني زي عندنا نقول the Minister of the Justice Department. It's high level. He was the Mufti. Mufti. You know the Mufti? And he was the Imam of the Masjid al-Amawi. He was the high knowledge in Syria. So what happened? He came in a member of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in جامع الأموي. اعتاد الناس في هذا العصر أن الإمام يدعو للسلطان عقب كل صلاة. Usually, any imam in even the big masjid like this imam, العز بن عبد السلام, after he finish خطبة الجمعة, Friday خطبة, he making دعاء for السلطان. If he didn't make this دعاء, that means it's big problem. You have to make a دعاء. So when Izzuddin ibn Abd al-Salam, Sultan al-Ulama, he hear what happened, he hear the Sultan asking the Christian, he help him against the Muslim, his brother, his nephew, and the Muslim people in Egypt. This happened, he started in the khutbah, Ankara zalika fil khutbah. بل دعا ان هذا السلطان قد خان الله ورسوله. He started in the khutbah said the sultan he is cheating Allah and his messenger. He cheating the Muslim people. He's khayin because he asking non-Muslim to help him out against the Muslim people. وفي نهاية الخطبة لم يدعو له بل قال اللهم قيد لهذه الأمة أمر رشد يعز فيها أهل طاعتك ويذل فيها أهل معصيتك ويؤمر فيها بالمعروف وينهى فيها عن المنكر. He making this dua and he do not make dua to the sultan. When the sultan hear that after khutbah he arrest him and put him in the jail. اعتقلوه فورا. As in his color, he said the reality absolutely goes to the jail. You need to know more and more. Here, Sheikh Abd al-Hamid Kishki, rahmahullah, about his silb, about his Sayyid Qutb, about a lot of ulama. Subhanallah, what happened to the scholar when he said the reality? He goes to the jail. But the point here, dear brother in Islam, the people, sharp, imaqib sharp. لما الشيخ كشك رحمه الله دخل السجن وعذب وهو كان حليم شعب مصر. الشيخ كشكي is was famous one in Egypt, not a scholar. But when he went to jail, nobody did anything. حتى قال والله لو كان ذبابا لسمعنا لهم طنين. يعني if the fly, we're gonna hear sound. Nobody did anything. At this time was very scary. يعني كان الحيطان ده وجان وكان ممنوع حد يتكلم. No one can talk. عز بن عبد السلام when he went to jail, لما اعتقلوه الشعب كله قام. All the Syrian people have run away. No way to put him in the jail. That's why he took him off right away. ولكن وضعوه في بيته مع منع ال يعني he isolated him inside his house. No way he can go out. الحقيقة في روايات كثيرة جدا مسموعة ومقروءة على أنه وضع في يده يعني a lot of story if you read about عز بن عبد السلام at this time he put him in the handcuff and he took him with him in the war. A lot of story. I don't want to make you confused. But the point is قرر العز بن عبد السلام سلطان العلماء أن يترك الشام ويذهب إلى مصر. He decided he will leave the Sham and he go to Egypt. And he already went to Egypt. نجم الدين أيوب, the one the Sultan in Egypt, he is very famous, very personality, شخصية مهابة. يعني يقولون كانوا يقبلون الأرض بين يديه. The people was respect him and scared from him. Very famous. When he hear العز بن عبد السلام coming to him, right away, he hiring him وزير العدل. يعني قاضي القضاء. The minister of the justice in Egypt. And he's a big mufti. And he's a big imam. And no one can do anything in the sharia without opinion of العز بن عبد السلام. كان في الوقت ده يا اخوانا انا نسيت نقطة معينة والله سمعتها. يعني I forgot one point. العز بن عبد السلام وهو في الشام من الأسباب اللي زعلته from the reason he why he got upset he gave